go and debate him.
Okay.
No, go and debate him.
But he's not debating him.
So, so now what we have is this. This individual is still trying to cover up his lies. Lying once isn't good enough. He lies again to cover up his lies. Do you know about the lies? Do you know something about the lies?
You lie about the Quran,
if you lie once,
you lie about the Quran,
you have to break up so many other lies to cover up your lies. Right. So now, again, another accusation. Another accusation. Now, I'm actually debating him. Do you know what's happening? These individuals have no integrity. I made statements even before the debate with Hatun, the one who squeaks, what's it called? Screams, right?
What's the point
that he's just made now. I never said in any of my interaction, you see, he cut me off. I never stated in any of my interactions ever in this park or in my recorded appearance anywhere else that the Hafs Qurans, for example, are exactly the same. We even had a discussion on the ladder. It's recorded in SC Dawa channel. Where we showed from a big chart where all the differences, even in articulation, whether you say wasama or wasama, do you see the differences in elongation?
But do you admit you?
Excuse me. I'm making a point. Excuse me. I said.
Do you admit you said that?
I said that they are preserved even to those differences of sounds, right?
But did you say not even a dot has changed?
Listen.
I'm asking a question.
Try to listen, then you'll learn. Right. I said that they are all preserved. And what happens is, some people with comprehension problem, and it seems to be the majority of the Christians here, unfortunately, they come along and say, oh, Mansoor said, they're all the same. How many videos can you go and see?
They said not a dot has been changed.
I said they are preserved even to the dots. Do you know what dot means in the transmission of the Quran?
Did you say not a dot has been changed?
No, I never said that. That is my claim. But people like him, people like him, and the one. No.
He's just going to put the
Do you want to understand? It's the first question.
No, but I'm asking for clarification.
Do the Christians want to understand? That's the first question. Do they actually want to understand the Islamic perspective?
I'm asking for clarification.
If you do,
good.
Listen to him.
Good.
See, what you're saying from an Islamic perspective, that's fine. I'm asking his exact words.
My exact words is recorded in many channels.
Listen
in SC Dawa channel, right? I said they are preserved. Even to the souls, right? Do you know how they're preserved? Let me tell you what a dot is. Do you know what a dot is in the Quranic reading? What is a dot?
Go on, explain.
No, guess. What is a dot in a reading? I never said it's in reading. I'm talking about how they are transmitted in the Mus'hafs. In a reading, when you read them, they are pronounced the same, right? The words. There is not even an additional chapter or a surah. There is no additional ayah or a verse. There is no additional or omission of a word is exactly the same. This is what it is in the reading of the Hafs.
So you didn't mean a literal dot.
So when I talked about the Mus'haf, I said the preservation even to this level. For example, I even used the example of da'ufa, du'fin and da'fin. Now let me ask you, do you hear the difference? Da'fin and du'fin. Is there a difference?
Yes.
There is a difference. So when I said even to that difference between a haraka, a vowel, right, of a or u, even to that level is preserved. Now, if someone comes along and says, oh, it means there is no change even to this, what are you going to say? Is that what I'm claiming?
You asked for three things.
I'm claiming that they are preserved even to this level of differences.
But did you say it was preserved to the dot?
I said, look. Isa, I have to bring it over.
I said exactly what I said earlier. You are talking about intricate academic
details. Absolutely.
Details. Right. These guys, unfortunately, they are not able to understand what you're talking about. You can bang your head against the wall all day.
Okay. What is a dot? What is a dot?
I'm just asking for.
Let me tell you. A dot in the Islamic academic understanding, right, is when you write something with a dot. In the Quranic manuscripts, it refers to either a diacritical point to differentiate between, say, ba and a ta, or a noon or a ya.
You have a Mus'haf.
or vowelization, that you make them into different vowels.
So let's agree, that's, you use the phrase preserved to the dot, you were using the Arabic.
Can you read it?
Arabic desk.
Can you read it?
I can't read it, no.
So okay. What are you talking about?
It's all right.
To me. How can we explain?
He's spoken for very long.
No, it's not a cop out. Let me explain something to you. If we are discussing a text,
yes,
and the questioner has no idea as to how that text is,
yes,
put down, written, the traditional way of writing it, or how the tradition is.
Wait.
The point
is, you're complaining three different things.
Wait.
His explanation.
How can he possibly explain a phenomenon to you do not understand?
But his word is now dot while speaking the English language.
So where's the dot? Can you show me the dot?
Listen, if the brother used the word dot while speaking English, we assume he's referring to the English definition of a dot, not the Arabic definition.
Your assumption is, you're faulty with your assumption then. So now, that's why.
You assumed you meant an English dot.
So you assumed, wrong. Did you ask for a clarification?
It shouldn't be needed.
Hang on. Of course it's needed. We were talking about...
No.
Why are you arguing with him?
We are...
You're asking him...
What a shame.
You don't try and understand.
First of all, let me ask him.
Okay, go on.
Are you asking him or arguing with him?
I am attempting to understand him.
Okay.
Good.
In that attempt, there is a basic prerequisite.
Yes.
And that is to pay attention and listen. Right? Ladies... You cannot argue with him.
Okay.
I'll tell you why. Because you do not have the knowledge he has.
I do not.
Right. So don't argue with
we're
him.
Not arguing about
ask
the
him and listen
Everything
to the answer and leave it at that.
Right.
If you want to argue, demonstrate the ability to argue on that particular topic.
Okay.
If you don't have the ability to argue on that particular topic, then listen, please.
Okay. Right. Can I say a sentence?
You are either teaching or learning.
Tell me if it's true or false.
Go.
Did you use the word dot in that phrase? And is it wrong of us to assume that you meant the English definition?
Can you quote me exactly?
I'm quoting the brother here. I haven't watched the video.
Then don't make a claim anything like that. Okay, maybe he can quote me. Quote me exactly.
Let me ask you.
I can paraphrase.
No.
Even to the
paraphrase. That is your mistake.
You mean the video?
Yeah, go ahead. Take the video.
No.
Don't misquote me because we know.
Did you say one we preserve to the dot? Yes or no?
Listen. What I said...
You say the Christians never give you a yes or no answer.
Excuse me.
For a yes or no answer.
Excuse me. My friends, right? Yes. You're here trying to misquote me, as you've been doing all along.
So the answer is no, you didn't say that.
So the answer is, what did I say, then say, did I say that?
Yes.
Go back to what I said.
If you didn't say that,
no,
why are you...
Go back to what I said.
We're going on a tangent. Can we...
Go ahead.
Do you know what he said?
No, but...
Do you remember what he said?
I'm trying to ask what he said, and he's not giving me a yes or no.
Pull it out, play it, and then we talk about it.
I want to discuss something different with you.
Did he use that phrase?
Otherwise, we talk about something else.
Yeah, let's talk about something else.
No, no, no.
We know what the Quranic preservation means.
Yes or no answer.
And the Christians are the last people on the planet to talk about preservation.
Okay,
if we... The questions they ask about the Quran, valid questions,
yes.
Academic questions, which we are happy to answer.
Okay.
When we apply the same questions to the biblical text, you have no legs to stand on. You guys are a bunch of hypocrites.
This isn't about the Quran.
You guys, it's like kettle telling the pot of black. It's like kettle telling the pot of black.
The other problem is, they can't even quote me right.
Yes.
Look how incapable they are.
I asked you if you said it, I wasn't quoting you.
Go ahead, he memorized it. Go ahead.
He said the Quran has been preserved even to the dot, letter, sound, and vowel.
Yes, we stand by that.
Yes.
Yes, we stand by that.
We call you. Sorry, why are you calling us a liar then?
Yes.
That's what he demonstrated. Dauphin and Dauphin, even to the dot, which represents a vowel, even to that level is being preserved.
No, wait. What is our claim? Let me put it simply so that you understand. Our claim is that we have every single word of the Quran transmitted to us directly from the Prophet. This is what our claim is. Now look at your face.
When did the Prophet get the word?
Yes.
When did the Prophet get the word?
No. This is what our claim. And we will stand by. I want you to make
was
the same face about
after
Mark. I want you to make the same face about Mark. Can you make the same face about Mark? Gospel of Mark.
Okay.
Mark. Luke.
Okay.
John.
Yeah. Okay.
Can you make the same face? Can you repeat my words? Can you repeat my words? We claim that the Gospel of Mark has been transmitted to us in the very wording he wrote. Repeat that.
Can you claim that?
Can you claim that? Can you claim that? Hello?
Wait.
Can you repeat that?
Why was the evidence
This is how you are a bunch of hypocrites.
Okay.
This is why we don't like talking to people like you.
Let me.
That's why, because you are a bunch of hypocrites.
Okay.
You throw something at us, and you guys, as I said, the cattle telling the pot you black.
You've made a very good point. Now,
you can never repeat that claim. any Christian here, any Christian missionary or activist or scholar or a student, whoever you are, can you claim, make this claim? The Gospel of Mark has been transmitted to us in the very wording Mark wrote once upon a time.
Okay,
I want you, anyone, anyone who is able to say these words, anyone,
your proof
has been no. We kept our evidence. The answer is no.
Okay.
Are you a Christian?
Yes, I am.
Okay, so can you help us?